And an alert, we're getting brand new video into the newsroom showing the destruction in St. Louis, Missouri. You'll remember these tornadoes slammed into the area Friday, very powerful. New reports show that nearly 2,700 buildings all around that city were damaged, about 100 homes outright destroyed. There were no deaths as a result of the 135-mile-an-hour tornado, but the National Weather Service says it was the most powerful twister in St. Louis since 1967. And this incredible surveillance video of a tornado slamming into the airport there in St. Louis. It shattered windows, ripped off part of the roof. Passengers inside were warned to get away from the windows, and they've been scrambling for safety.
We look out next to us, and we see the plane and the gate, you know, right to our left, just immediately slides about 15 or 20 yards away from the gate. At that point, everyone on our plane just immediately started streaming for the exit. Luckily, we were still connected to the gate, so we were able to run off. And by the time you get to the terminal, I mean, we got to the terminal, lights were out, there was glass everywhere, it was just open, there was blood everywhere from where people had been cut.
And that twister also flattened whole neighborhoods, destroyed hundreds of homes. Rick Reichmuth is in Bridgeton, Missouri, with a live look at the damage, and those pictures speak volumes, Rick.
Yeah, they really do, Shannon. You're saying it was the strongest tornado in the St. Louis area since 1967. It's also the strongest tornado we've seen in the country this year, the first EF4 rated tornado we've had. And you get that, and this is the kind of damage that it does. These are brick structured homes. These aren't small and insignificant homes, but when you have bricks like this strewn about and destroyed, that tells you how strong this was. This home, all of the outside walls completely collapsed. And a sad story with this home was up for sale and had a sale pending. They were supposed to close on Thursday. And the woman who was buying it so excited to move here because her sister lives right down the street. Her sister's home sustaining significant damage, and now she probably can't buy this home either. You can see down the street a car turned upside down. Just devastation everywhere you turn, and now everybody has to figure out what you do. The first couple of days have been spent getting their things that matter to them out, things like pictures, family heirlooms, and photographs, and they've done that. Now they're at the point you got to figure out what to do. How do you just bulldoze the whole thing over immediately? Want to point out there's a house right next door to this one. This one's leveled. House next door not sustaining real significant damage. And that's one of the crazy things about tornadoes and making it so hard for people to just wrap their minds around it. I do want to take you to the back side of this house. You can see all the walls gone. A lot of the basements, though, still standing, which was great news and saved a lot of people. But you go into the backyards, and it's hard to tell whose yard is whose yard and which part of one house belongs to who. And people are saying their neighbors from a mile away are coming up to them with pictures that they're finding that have flown all the way over into the other neighborhood. So the one thing I would say, this was Good Friday, and with an EF4 tornado, Shannon, not a single fatality and not any even real significant injuries. And that's the one thing that people in this community are laughing. They're having a good time and banding together and saying they're closer than they've ever been. And they're also thankful that there weren't any of these fatalities.